Today, America's wars have faded from the headlines. And veterans' issues seem to be forgotten, at least by the mainstream media. Well, here, we remember our veterans, and we stand by them, as I know that many of you do. And as many of you know, veteran suicide is still a problem in America. If today's a typical day, 20 veterans will take their lives today. Between 2005 and 2017, 78,875 veterans took their own lives. That's according to the most recent data from the VA. That's more than the number of Americans who died in each major conflict except for World War II and the Civil War. And if you've ever known someone who committed suicide, or if you've known the family of someone who's committed suicide, you know that there are no numbers that can convey the searing, tearing, awful, and forever pain that is caused by even one suicide. So what do we do? First, we have to recognize that you cannot solve this veteran suicide problem with money alone. The VA budget is over $230 billion, and the tens of billions of additional dollars haven't yet moved the numbers on suicide. Part of the problem is simply that bureaucracies focus on problems. They focus on substance abuse, joblessness, mental health issues, PTSD, loneliness. Now, I know that we can do better. When I came home from Iraq, after my team was hit by a suicide truck bomb, I donated my combat pay and started working with veterans around the country. We worked with men and women who'd lost limbs, who'd lost eyesight, those who had traumatic brain injuries, and many who felt utterly lost. We changed lives and we saved lives because rather than focusing on problems and wounds, we focused on solutions and strengths. Our message to veterans was simple. We still need you. And we put them back to work, coaching martial arts, building with Habitat for Humanity, leading efforts to end homelessness. And you know what happened? When people have a purpose, they rise, they work, they get themselves cleaned up, they go back to school, they walk with pride. Now, in addition to helping people rebuild a sense of purpose, we also had to love veterans enough to be straight and brave with them. We had to tell them the truth. Suicide is not what warriors do. The first purpose of the warrior is to protect others. Suicide makes that impossible. In suicide, someone takes their pain, multiplies it by 10, and hands it to everyone who loves them. What was hurting them becomes hell the people who love them. There is something selfish about that. And that's a hard thing to say. I've known veterans who've committed suicide, and you may have known some too. I say it not because we want to criticize the dead, but because we want to help veterans. Suicide is not what warriors do. What warriors do is act with compassion and kindness toward those who need it. If you've been with people who are struggling, you will know how profoundly a word of kindness can help someone who's shaking on the hard edge of making a very bad choice. And today, in a world in which politicians have imposed joblessness and isolation on tens of millions of Americans, and in a public culture in which the mainstream media seems almost completely devoid of any sense of forgiveness, compassion, humanity, or grace, it's all the more important that we act with kindness toward one another. These are simple things: a sense of purpose, bravery, kindness. They can change lives and save lives. And that's something that we can all do together. Now, you all remember, this is a country built by real American heroes. And here on Actionable Intelligence, we honor those heroes. And tonight, we honor St. Louis Police Captain David Dorn. He gave his life when he was murdered by looters in the city of St. Louis. Many of you remember his wife, Ann Dorn, who joined us for the Blue Courage Special. She's been a model of courage and hope. We honor her, and we remember the family of David Dorn. We'll be back in just a minute.